Welcome friends, I am Tonmoy. Today we are going to discuss about diisobutylaluminium hydride, preparation properties, its reactivity and its comparison with traditionally established reducing agent, that is lithium aluminium hydride. So let's start. Before going to details, I want to introduce myself. Currently I am doing PhD at Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, Kolkata. And if you like my videos, please share. Subscribe my channel, The Chemistry, The Mystery of Molecules. So let's go to the main study. This is the name of this material, and actually this reagent look like this hydride. And before going to details, we will learn about the hybridization of this aluminium atom. Actually it is sp2 hybridized. How? This aluminium has a valence shell of 3s2 and 3p1, means 2 electron in s orbital, 1 in p orbital. It undergo hybridization to form this 3sp2 orbital with singly occupied and one vacant orbital which do not have any electron. This is a vacant. And if we observe that this forms a bond with one carbon, this forms another bond with carbon, and this forms a bond with hydrogen, means one electron comes from hydrogen and form this bond with this in this using this orbital. One electron coming from carbon and forms bond using these orbitals. Okay. So this is the main introduction. So right now we will discuss its preparation. Actually, unlike other aluminium hydrides like lithium aluminium hydrides, this dibal is prepared from trialkyl aluminium or trimer or tri this secondary butyl aluminium, means this tries this secondary aluminium reagent, means 3 aluminium upon heating it produces this reagent, and the another product which is produced, that is this dimethyl ethylene. And this process happens via beta hydrogen elimination. Let's explain. Initially, this trialkyl aluminium, that is, let's consider other as R group, is this one. And if we consider this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon. So hydride elimination will occur from this beta carbon. Okay. So let's draw this hydride. And right now what happens? Upon heating, this bond goes here and this will go to aluminium to form this region. So I want to give a little description of the transition state. Actually, it is important. It is a four-member cyclic TS. Means how does it look like? We will first draw the unaffected bonds using this plain line. And we will give dotted line to the bonds which are formed or broken during the process. This is hydride. So this is the structure of the TS, transition state. And what are the number? Since I am saying four member ring, then one atom, 2, 3, 4. These four atoms are forming this four-member ring. for this beta hydrogen elimination pathway. Okay, so this is the preparation of this alkyl aluminium reagent. So let's discuss about its reactivity. From my previous video, which is about lithium aluminium hydride, you can understood, I guess you have understood, that this lithium aluminium hydrides react violently with water, and similar property is observed in case of this dibal hydrogen. The most important point of this reagent is that it contains an aluminium hydrogen bond. This aluminium hydrogen bond, and this hydrogen is delta negative and aluminium is delta positive. And if we compare this with sodium borohydride, this also delta negative, this also delta positive. But if we go down along a period, electronegativity decreases and bond length, sorry, from here boron, here aluminium, here gallium, if we go, that bond length increases. Okay, so here this bond is longer compared to this, this is smaller. So bond longer means similarly bond is weaker. Second, this aluminium has more electropositive character compared to boron, so it will prefer, or it will allow the hydrogen to keep more negative charge concentrated on him. And that is the one of the most important reason for excessive high reactivity of this reagent. And second point is the Lewis acidity of aluminium, because this aluminium is in tricoordinated state, means it is 6 electron species and it needs electron to satisfy its electron deficiency. And another point I want to mention here is that this reagent prefers to remain in a dimeric form, R1, R2, R1, R2. This R is equal to secondary butyl. Okay, these two hydride forms a bridge and this gets stabilized, and this is octet field. This is similar like this 3 center 2 electron bond in case of B2H6. Okay, now this is a 6 electron species, so aluminium needs some Lewis base and hydride need some proton source. This is delta plus, this is delta minus, and it reacts violently with water. Why? Because water has this delta negative oxygen and delta positive hydrogen, and the reaction ultimately produces hydrogen gas and aluminium hydroxide, because this hydrogen production is nothing but the delta H and delta, this positive proton and negative hydride, means H plus plus H minus, which this is no electron and this is 2 electron, ultimately produces the hydrogen gas which goes outside. So that's why it reacts violently with water. Similarly, it reacts with methanol. Why? Because methanol also have this polar hydrogen and this polar oxygen. So that's why these isobutyl aluminium hydride reagents are reacted in solvents like hexane or ether. Another important reason why this reagent is soluble in hexane, because hexane is a very nonpolar solvent, and we have found that sodium borohydride, lithium aluminium hydride doesn't dissolve in hexane, This is because this is a neutral molecule and this contains different R group, which is alkyl group, that is butyl group. That's why it's soluble in hexane, and all the reaction need to be performed in anhydrous solvents. Okay, so this is the brief introduction about the property. So let's go to the most important application of this reagent as a, that is as a reducing agent. Why? Let's check. We are saying it's reducing agent, so it actually reduces carbonyl into corresponding alcohol. Okay, here the oxidation state of this carbon is plus 2, and here after reduction it became 0 and it became plus 1. So the reduction of at the carbon center happened, that's why this reaction is called reduction reaction. And why this happened? This is positive, this is negative, and this bond attacks here and the reaction happens. Okay, let's discuss little briefly how this reaction happening, or you can say its mechanism. Actually, this initially this carbonyl, A, let's consider this alkyl group as R, so R2H. First, this carbonyl group attach with aluminium center via Lewis acid bridge interaction. Why? Because this contains Lu lone pair, and another thing, it can have a resonance structure where the oxygen is minus, means 3 lone pair, and this carbon is plus, but the contribution of this charged species to the overall canonical form is less. So this is little electron rich, so that will, it will coordinate with aluminium, and one adduct will form, and due to this coordination aluminium will have a formal positive charge, formal negative charge, and oxygen will have a formal positive charge, and then hydride here. After coordination, the electron deficiency of this carbon increases further, because oxygen is electronegative atom and it donates electron to this aluminium center. Consequently, it became more electron deficient, so it will pull this electron density out this side more, so it will become more electrophilic, and here, that time this hydride will attack here. Okay, so what will be the product? This is hydride, this is oxygen, this is aluminium, and after aluminium R2, after workup, it produces the secondary alcohol. Okay, this property indicates that its similarity with lithium aluminium hydride as well as sodium borohydride. So right now we are going to discuss about one of its unique property of these aluminium hydrides, that is as a reducing agent for the reduction of ester into aldehyde. In case of lithium aluminium hydride, we have observed that it reduces the ester completely to alcohol or nitrile to amine. But here it will reduce that ester or nitrile into selectively aldehyde. How? Let's consider this ester. What happens? First, it forms an adduct with this aluminium center I have explained just sometimes before. Okay, this is a 1 unit formal positive charge and 1 unit negative charge. Now this hydride attacks here. Okay, so this produces OR. Actually, this proton is coming from aluminium. Keep it in mind, it will be important. So if we look at the condition required for this reaction, is it is done in hexane and the temperature is minus 70 degree centigrade. This is very important to maintain low temperature to have selectively aldehyde. Otherwise it, aldehyde may be further reduced to corresponding alcohol. Okay, why this temperature is important? Because the this intermediate is formed, after that it is getting hydrolyzed with water to produce the corresponding hydride OME OH, and it further protonates this position and this methanol goes out after protonation, which results in formation of aldehyde. Okay, this is the thing. Actually, this at this minus 70 degree centigrade, this one is getting sterilized. Sterilized, that's why water can hydrolyze this, break this bond and hydrolyze this hemiacetal into corresponding aldehyde. But if not, suppose if let's increase the temperature, what will happen? If we increase the temperature, this lone pair of oxygen will come here and it will push and it will produce OR plus hydrogen and this aluminium alkyl oxygen species. Okay, so this is also a carbonyl group, and another thing, it is more activated compared to ester, so it may be further reduced using this aluminium hydride, understood, to corresponding alcohol. That is the main reason to keep this temperature minus 70 degree. Now you can ask me a question, that why this? We will add selectively one equivalent reagent, then this selective one equivalent reagent will further attack to one equivalent of ester, and that will produce ultimately one equivalent of this aldehyde, no need to maintain. Apparently it looks right, but if we look at the real scenario, that is, such type of this reagent which are very reactive always take slight excess of compared to stoichiometry. For example, if we take 1 millimole, it is better to take 1.2 millimole. Why? Because in the reaction medium there could be some moisture, solvent may have some moisture, reagent may have some moisture, there is as an impurity, that water that may react violently with this, so some amount of reagent will be wasted, first point. Second, it is not true that whenever I mix these two reagents, these two will react instantly with each other from 1:1. There may be some product, some material which will not react. And another thing, this adduct formation actually reversible in nature. Okay, so it can break and go back to these reagents. So what may happen? That when some amount of aldehyde is produced, and in the medium there is some amount of this alkyl lithium reagent, it will react and it will result into that corresponding alcohol. So what will we get ultimately? We will not find 100% conversion of a particular product, first point is true, and second point, we will end up with a mixture of aldehyde as well as alcohol. But we don't need mixture, we need a pure product. That's why we need to be careful about this temperature. So I request you to memorize this temperature properly. Don't forget about this temperature. Okay, so let's now discuss about the reduction of alkyl nitrile group alkyl or aryl nitrite. Nitrile means cyanide with this reagent. What happens, this cyanide also has a lone pair, this nitrile, so it can form a bond, means coordinate bond with aluminium, and this is 2R and another thing is H, and this can attack this material, and at this low temperature the intermediate is stable, and what will produce ultimately, this RC double bond N Al R2 and here hydride. Okay, now if you look at this, it's a imine of aldehyde, so when it's hydrolyzed this is hydrolyzed and first this is hydrolyzed and ultimately it produces the aldehyde molecule. Okay. So I guess you have understood this. So up to this study, I want to give you a question. Question is, how to convert aldehyde into RCHOH to corresponding deuterated product. Okay, I guess you have understood how to convert this to the corresponding deuterium product. I will give the answer of this question at the end of this video. So I guess we have discussed the main property of this lithium, this aluminium hydride. So let's compare this reagent with lithium aluminium hydride. Why? Because lithium aluminium hydride is easily available, widely used material. Why to use a special reagent like this DIBAL-H? So let's take DIBAL-H and lithium aluminium hydride. Okay. So this DIBAL-H, first of all, it's a neutral molecule, no charge. There is a polarity of this aluminium hydrogen bond. This is delta positive, but this is delta negative. But that is, it doesn't mean it's charged. Majority of organic molecules, or intersect, all the molecules with heteroatomic bond are polar in nature. But it doesn't mean that they are charged. This is not charged, but this is a salt, completely charged molecule forming lithium plus ion and air H4 minus. Secondly, it contains bulky group. This isobutyl group is bulky, but it doesn't contain any bulky group because all of the hydrides and central metal is aluminium, which is relatively bigger in size compared to sodium borohydride. This is a bigger, and this one also, this is not bulky group. This reagent does not contain bulky group. Okay, I guess understood. The third and the most important reaction is, okay, another point we can make that this is relatively less reactive compared to this because of the hybridization of this orbital. It is, you can consider it as a sp2, it is sp3, more directional property. So 3 sp2, this is sp3, so more directional property and more nucleophilic nature in case for this compared to this. Okay, I guess these are the points I have explained, and the most important difference of this dibal hydrogen and lithium aluminium hydride is the way to react with the reagent, means strategy to react with the carbonyl groups. Or you can say, for example, let's take ester. Means what I want to say, this dibal, if I draw this R1, and let's draw this lithium aluminium hydride. This is the sp3 center. These are the hydrides. Minus lithium. This material contains a vacant p orbital, okay, and it is sextate, means 6 electron species. This doesn't contain any vacant p orbital and it is octet, 8 electron species, okay. So it desperately needs electron. What happens, for example, one ester molecule, R O R1, And we know that this oxygen is little more electron rich because of resonance. But I'll show this and this. What the canonical form happens? After resonance, formal charge of oxygen is plus and this is minus. Okay. So that's why this oxygen atom becomes highly electron rich. And it is capable to donate its electron pair to other molecules. For example, it is capable to donate its electron pair to the central aluminium to form an adact with this aluminium R2 and this ROR1. With a formal positive charge on oxygen and a negative charge. I guess we have understood. Okay, let's explain. Then this hydride attacks here. So first it is electrophilic activation then nucleophilic attack. Okay, but here what happens? It directly attacks to this because it is not coordinatively unsaturated, it has four attachment. So this oxygen can't attach to the aluminium center. So this is nucleophilic activation. Okay, I guess you have understood. This is the main difference of the reaction between this dibal hydride, this aluminium hydride and lithium aluminium hydride. Okay, so this is the end of the video and I shall explain the question what I have asked previously. And the question was the conversion of this hydrogen of air on the more specifically we can say that the replacement of that aldehyde hydrogen with a deuterium selectively. How could it be possible? Since I have asked this during this study of this aluminium reagent, then definitely one of the example should go through this for how this. If we check the mechanistic reduction, check the mechanism of reduction of ester, what happens? If we use this secondary butyl aluminium hydride, this hydride attacks here. And ultimately produces this R. COH. Now you can also understand what I want to mean. Instead of this aluminium hydride, let's take the aluminium deuterium reagent. Short is butyl aluminium deuterate. Then definitely this hydrogen will be replaced by deuterium. Simple answer. But there is some problem. Actually, for academic purpose or understanding of this literature point of view, it is okay. You will understand. But what is the real problem? Because preparation of this reagent is a real problem. So I shall give you a real route to convert this aldehyde into this hydrogen containing aldehyde into a deuterium containing aldehyde. Let's look at very carefully. I request you to look at this very carefully. Okay, this is hydrogen. Now, let's react this thing with this 1,2-diethyl. Okay, what will ultimately happen? It is like a acetal formation, is thioacetal formation. This, sorry, not oxygen, I made the mistake. Thioacetal formation, this is R. Now, if this reagent is treated with butyl lithium, it produces, that it abstracts this hydrogen. I'll explain why. This minus and nitrile plus. This negative charge is stabilized by the coordination with the sulfur. For example, how? This sulfur carbon negative. Negative means this is in p orbital, a pair of electron. And similarly, sulfur has d orbital. Okay, so it can form bond with your metal, means it can delocalize this electron to this sulfur and this sulfur, and in this way this reagent is getting stabilization. And this stabilization doesn't mean it's okay, very stable, cool, we can handle it in here. No, I am saying relative stabilization. It is getting relative stabilization due to this presence of two sulfur. Now let's put D2O. Because it's a negative charge species, carbon ion, and in D2O, the thing is that D contains delta positive, O is delta more negative. Okay, so it can react, this can abstract this proton. It happens, and what ultimately produce? Deuterium containing thioacetal. Okay, now if we do the reverse step of this, then we will have the aldehyde back with deuterium. How to cleave this thioacetal? This is possible in case of mercury 2 plus. Why? Because sulfur is a soft center. So it will attract soft. If there is oxygen, then we can use simply proton, that is hard acid. This is soft acid. So it will hydrolyze, and corresponding the deuterium containing aldehyde will be produced. So this is the end of the video. So, tomorrow we will explain about some other borohydride or aluminium hydride reagent, means specific or special borohydride or aluminium hydride reagent, and we will check their reactivity. So, thank you everyone for listening my video, and if you like my videos, please share, comment and subscribe my channel, and see you in the next video.